In this video, we're going to practice solving equations that involve trig functions. So let's start with part A. In part A, we're asked to solve the equation root 2 sine of x minus 1 equals 0. So let's start by isolating the sine of x. If we do that, we get sine of x equals 1 over root 2. And I'm actually going to rewrite this 1 over root 2 so that it's a more familiar value to us. And the way I'm going to do that is by a process called rationalizing the denominator. And here that's going to mean multiplying top and bottom by root 2 over 2. By doing this, I'm multiplying by 1, so I'm not actually changing the expression. I'm just rewriting it. So if I follow through with this, I get sine of x equals root 2 over 2. That should be a more familiar number for you. Hopefully you recognize that value from the unit circle. So what is it going to mean for us to solve this equation? Because we haven't actually isolated x at this point. Instead, we have sine of x equals root 2 over 2. Well, what we're actually going to do to answer this question is we're going to find all angles for which the sine is root 2 over 2. That's what it's going to mean for us to solve this equation. So hopefully you already know some angles where the sine is root 2 over 2, but just to be sure, let's take a look at the unit circle together. So here's my unit circle, and I'm looking for angles where the sine is root 2 over 2. So remember that when you're looking at points on the unit circle, that the x value is your cosine, and the y value is your sine. So I'm looking for angles where the y value is root 2 over 2. So the first one I notice here in the first quadrant is pi over 4. Right here, the sine is root 2 over 2. And then if I look in the second quadrant, I see another angle, 3 pi over 4, that has a sine value of root 2 over 2. Now, once I get into the third and the fourth quadrant, my sine values are negative. So this pi over 4 and 3 pi over 4 are the values I'm interested in. So then, so far what we've discovered is that x equals pi over 4 and x equals 3 pi over 4 are solutions to this relationship, right? The sine of pi over 4 is root 2 over 2, and the sine of 3 pi over 4 is root 2 over 2. But are those the only solutions to this equation? Right? I'm trying to find all the x's that satisfy this relationship. Well, what we have to remember here is we have to remember that the sine is a periodic function. That means that its values repeat itself. And specifically, the sine has a period of 2 pi. So what does that mean for us in this context? Let's think about the solution x equals pi over 4 for a minute. So here's my solution. An angle of pi over 4, and that is at the point root 2 over 2, root 2 over 2 on the unit circle. But like we just said, the sine is periodic. So if I were to go one full trip around the unit circle and come back to that point, I would find another solution to my expression because I would be back at the same point or the same value. Or I could go two trips around the unit circle, or three trips around, or four trips around, or any number of trips around the unit circle and get back to another solution. Now, one trip around the unit circle is 2 pi radians. Additionally, I could even go the other direction, so the clockwise or the negative direction around the unit circle, and get to other solutions that way. Here you can think of going negative 2 pi around the unit circle. So basically then what I've discovered is that any either positive or negative multiple of 2 pi is going to get me back to another solution. So how am I going to actually going to write this? Well, I can write pi over 4 plus 2 n pi, where n is an integer, that is 0, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, so on. So basically, pi over 4 plus any integer multiple of 2 pi, whether that integer is positive or negative, is also going to be a solution to this expression. And same thing with the 3 pi over 4. So this gets me all the solutions to my equation, and we see that there are actually infinitely many of them. Now let's take a look at part B together. In part B, we're asked to solve the equation cosine of 2x equals sine of 2x for x's between 0 and 2 pi. Now, because we're given a specific interval on x here, we're not going to have infinitely many solutions like we did in part A. We still are going to have, probably, more than one solution, but not infinitely many of them. So how do I think about this equation? Well, what I'm being asked to find is, essentially, where the cosine equals the sine. So let's start by thinking about the points on the unit circle where the cosine and the sine are equal. Well, let's go back and look at our unit circle here. So, if I look in the first quadrant here, I see at pi over 4 that the cosine and the sine are equal. They both have a value of root 2 over 2. So, scanning along here, I'm looking for other angles where that might be true, and here I see another one in the third quadrant at 5 pi over 4. Where both the sine and the cosine are negative root 2 over 2. And those are the only values I see on my unit circle here. So pi over 4 and 5 pi over 4 are going to be my starting points. But we saw in part A that the cosine and the sine functions are periodic. So these aren't necessarily the only places where the cosine equals the sine. So what I should really say, what are the points on the unit circle where cosine and sine are equal, are for theta equals pi over 4 plus 2n pi, and theta equals 5 pi over 4 plus 2n pi, where n is an integer. So you might be saying, well, but wait, we're only looking at x values between 0 and 2 pi. And that's true, but we haven't really actually started thinking about x values yet. Right now we're just thinking about the angles in general where the cosine and the sine are equal. So we'll get to that 0 to 2 pi in just a second. So we're not really done yet. Our answers are not pi over 4 and 5 pi over 4. Because I don't just have cosine x equals sine x, I have cosine 2x equals sine of 2x. So then what I'm really looking for here is I'm looking to find where 2x equals pi over 4 plus 2 n pi, and where 2x equals 5 pi over 4 plus 2 n pi. Right, because the angles where cosine and sine are equal are these angles here, pi over 4, 5 pi over 4, and they're multiples. But those angles right now are 2x, so I need to set 2x equal to pi over 4 plus 2 n pi, and 5 pi over 4 plus 2 n pi. And then I can solve these expressions for x. So here I'm going to get x equals pi over 8 plus n pi, and x equals 5 pi over 8 plus n pi. Okay, so right now I have infinitely many solutions, but I do want to restrict my final answer to x values between 0 and 2 pi. So 0 and 2 pi, another way I could write that is 0 and 16 pi over 8 would be equivalent to 2 pi. So I just want to pick out the values that are within that interval. So this pi over 8 plus n pi, so remember n is integers 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2, so then I get pi over 8. And if I add pi to that, that is going to give me 9 pi over 8. And if I add another pi to that, and the way I'm thinking about this is pi equals 8 pi over 8. That's going to give me 17 pi over 8, but now I am actually out of my interval, so I can stop. And I don't need to go in the negative direction, because if I subtract pi from this, I'm going to get something that's less than 0. So it looks like these are my two solutions here. We do the same thing for 5 pi over 8. If I add pi to that, if I add 8 pi over 8, I'm going to get 13 pi over 8. If I were to add another pi to that, I would get 21 pi over 8, but now I'm out of my interval. And in this case, it looks like we probably want to try subtracting a pi as well. So if I subtract pi from this, I'm going to get negative 3 pi over 8, okay, but that's too small. So then let's just list out all our solutions. So I've got pi over 8. I've got 5 pi over 8. I've got 9 pi over 8. And I've got 13 pi over 8. And you could verify these solutions by plugging them into the original relationship and making sure that the equation held.